I'll drink to that too.
Yeah, man,
you like it? Yeah, wash it down. Hey, go get it, baby. Specialist fourth class, Arlen Grove. 3rd Infantry Division, 2nd Battalion, Company E. Separated. Separated from what?
From my head, I think.
Aren't you going to say, where am I?
Well, where am I?
This is Morgan's Corner. I'm Molly Morgan. Uncle Ed and me run the place. What there is to run. A one-pump gas station and a grocery store.
Oops, I gotta go. There's a customer waiting. Now, you stay in bed till the doctor comes, you hear?
And all you got to do in your spare time is paint signs?
That means he likes it. You sure take good care of that guitar.
It's all I got. That and about 5 zillion songs in there.
Don't you want anything else?
Yeah. I'd like to make my mark in life. With music. You know, anything can be said with a song. I've got things I'd like to say. In my own way.
Don't you want a home?
I've got a home. But it's a long way from here.
I'm a long way from home, and so all alone, homesick like I never thought I'd be. I'm a long way from home, and everything is wrong. Someone please watch over me.
What you doing, mister?
I don't believe it. Go away, kid.
What you doing?
I'm trying to get something out of her eye.
That's right, little boy.
We want to watch you.
And now here he is, everybody's favorite, the funniest man in Searchlight, Uncle Ed Morgan. Here he is.
He's got to be kidding.
Nope. He never misses a hoot. Folks around here just love him.
Hey. Hey, fellas. Let's do a little bit of the mockingbird on the old biscuit board. Are you ready? Here we go.
Thank you.
Folks, we got a genuine army hero here tonight, and I understand he's a pretty good singer. So let's hear it for ex-soldier Arlen Grove.
Good luck, Arlen.
Nashville Rebel, they say leave that boy alone. Don't you give him advice or he'll turn to ice, and you might as well talk to stone. But I've got things to do and things to say in my own way. I don't have time for your parties or love's little guessing games. I've got songs to write in the still of night. I was born to write and sing, and I've got things to do and things to say in my own way. They call me the Nashville Rebel. Little girl, don't you waste your time, for I've given my heart to this old guitar. You deserve a better love than mine, and I've got things to do and things to say in my own way. I'm the Nashville Rebel. I'm a loner and I like it fine. I'd like to have a wife, live a normal life, but I just don't have the time, 'cause I've got things to do and things to say in my own way. I've got things to do and things to say in my own way.
You were great. They loved you.
That's right. Uncle Ed was right, boy. You're okay.
Well, thank you. A whole bunch. I can
tell you this. If you ever want to take this seriously, I got a job for you. Pay you $75 a week. So if you ever want to go to work, boy, you just see me.
Thank you. A whole bunch.
Okay.
He'll stand it till they throw him off that stage. You sure knocked him out tonight.
Get up. You're going to marry her.
Sure. Sure, we're going to get married.
Now, I mean now, you're going to marry her.
We can't do that. I mean, we got plans and... You just don't... We're gonna get married.
Now, by the power vested in me, by the sovereign state of Tennessee, I hereby pronounce you man and wife. That's all.
Ed? I'm sorry.
Here's a song that I wrote, and I'd like to do especially for my little wife, Molly.
Rain River, I come back to you. Do you remember me? Do you remember Molly, with the soft blue eyes? I left here with a lot of dreams, none of them came true. What I wanted was here waiting all the time.
Green River,
did she come here?
Green River,
every evening, like the neighbor said she did, so faithfully. Green River, has she gone away? She just disappeared one day. Yes, she gave up on me. Green River, if you see her, won't you tell her I'll return? All I brought her is myself and this little ring. Please tell her that I love her, and my lesson I have learned. Green River, tell her please come back to me.
What do you think of my new boy?
Not bad. Introduce me.
You're wonderful.
Hey, Arlen. Mr. Lang wanted to meet you.
Well, any friend of Hal's is a friend of ours. Pleased to meet you.
I'll see y'all later.
This is my wife, Molly. You've got a talented husband, Molly. And I know talent when I see it.
Well, thank you. Are you in business?
Oh, by profession, I'm an attorney. By instinct, I'm an investor. Like you, for instance. I might invest in you.
And me?
My instincts tell me that with the right kind of backing, you could be very big.
Well, where would I get that kind of backing?
I tell you what. Come out to my estate tomorrow morning and we'll talk about it.
Are you really serious?
I'll see you in the morning.
What do you think?
He's sure a mean man with a horse.
Sometimes I think he hates his horses.
Hey,
mackerel. Now that's Margot Powell. Beautiful, isn't she? I manage her estate. But you didn't come here to talk about other people's money. Sit down.
Oh, my. This is really something.
Cost over $200,000 to restore.
$200,000?
Yes, money talks. In your case, it sings. Now, when I heard you last night, I said, there goes $1 million talent. Right down the drain.
What do you mean by that?
Arlen, you're a good country western singer. Maybe even a great one. But you need a manager.
He's making $75 a week.
With his talent, he should be a star.
Yeah, me and Tex Ritter.
We're happy where we are.
I don't even own a necktie.
Well, that's the point. You need someone. I mean, someone who knows about neckties and publicity and booking.
You mean all I have to do is sing and a manager will take care of that?
That's it. You become a famous star and we both get rich. That is, if I'm your manager.
Do you think I can make it?
I happen to believe you're a walking, talking gold mine. You just keep on singing. Let me worry about the business.
Function is served, sir.
Is Miss Powell joining us?
No, sir. She's taking a nap, sir.
I'll take you to Nashville after lunch. An exact reproduction of the Greek Parthenon. But I want you to see something more important. I want you to hear Farron Young. You'll learn something.
Instead of having sweet dreams
about you. Start my life anew instead of having sweet dreams about you.
From here, Farron goes to Memphis, St. Louis, Phoenix, and Florida.
That must be a terrible way to live. Doesn't he ever get home?
Farron makes more than $250,000 a year at those prices. Who needs a home?
$250,000?
Mm-hmm.
Everybody needs a home.
All right, Mr. Lang. If you're still interested, what do I do first?
Move to Nashville. Margo, I've got some papers for you to sign.
For God's sake, Wesley. That's all I ever do, sign papers whenever I'm here.
Oh, I sympathize, Margo. But if you want to keep flitting around Europe with your jet set, the terrible penalty you have to pay. 10 minutes a year signing papers. If you're bored, I've got a job for you. I just bought a singer.
A real, live human being?
Of course.
I didn't think even you could do that anymore.
The kid doesn't know anything. You'll have to teach him how to talk, how to eat, how to dress. The facts of life.
A real, live singer?
Mm.
Fight big kicks.
Good. There's only one obstacle left. His wife may be a problem. But I'll handle that myself.
Boy, would you look at this. Well, this is a penthouse.
Oh, my.
I guess so. Lang's paying for it. Let's let him worry about it. Let's go out on the roof.
All right.
I've always wondered how the rich live. They live nice, huh, Molly?
It sure must be expensive.
Hey, look here. It's a real stud. Champagne. Wonder if I got any glasses. We're in business.
Well, I never had champagne before. What do you suppose it tastes like?
Y'all are just in time for a drink.
Good. Harlan, Molly, I'd like you to meet Margot Powell.
Hello.
How do you do, Miss Powell?
Nice to meet you.
Margot decorated the apartment.
I loved every minute of it. Well, Mr. Grove, I wish Wesley had more investments like you.
Margot's going to be your teacher, Harlan. Give you some polish. What to say, how to dress.
Arlen dresses all right.
Mrs. Grove, Arlen may look all right behind a gas pump, but they'll laugh him right off the stage in that hillbilly outfit.
She's right, Molly.
Mr. Lang knows what he's doing, huh?
You have an appointment with my tailor in half an hour. Margo will drive you.
Come along, Wonder Boy. Let's get this career started.
Be back in a little while, huh?
Door-to-door service, Mrs. Grove.
Champagne sure goes to your head, doesn't it?
Well, one doesn't guzzle champagne like beer, Molly. One sips it delicately.
Mr. Lang. Hmm? I appreciate everything you're trying to do for Arlen and me. Really, I do. But we'd be just as happy in a place that was less... Well, less,
Less imposing, Mrs. Grove?
Yes, that's it.
Well, let me give you some advice, Mrs. Grove. Start getting used to imposing things. Imposing apartments, imposing clothes, imposing automobiles. Because that's what success is all about. And Arlen is going to be a success. I am investing too much money to let anything or anyone come between Arlen and success.
Sounds pretty good to me.
Just make sure he's got that Nashville sound.
Oh, that's a built-in feature of our musicians and singers. That won't be any problem at all.
Good, good.
Hey, Grove, telephone.
Hello.
Happy anniversary, darling.
Anniversary?
Oh, silly. 2 months today.
I'll tell you what, I'll be kissing you in about 1 hour from right now.
I love you.
I love me, too.
You're impossible. I'll see you in an hour.
Okay, bye.
Oh, I've got some papers for you to sign.
What are they?
Contracts.
Hey, Grove, we're ready.
Just a second. Go on, sign them. Then we'll be legally married. Now, when you're through here, Margo has a newspaper interview set up for you, and then I want you to go to my tailor.
Okay.
Let's go, Grove.
Okay. Oh, I forgot. I promised Molly I was coming right home.
Go on. I'll call her.
Anniversary.
What's all this?
Where have you been?
Didn't Lane call?
Nobody called.
I'm sorry. I guess he forgot.
I'm sure he did.
No, I never heard that one before. What, are you drinking it straight?
I never spoil good scotch.
Well, here comes little Miss Buttercup. Well, have a drink, Mrs. Grove. We're celebrating. Waitress.
No, thank you.
I never heard of a woman refusing to drink to her husband's success before. Unless she didn't want him to be a success.
Wesley.
Hmm? Don't you want Arlen to be a success, Mrs. Grove?
I want Arlen to lead his own life.
Arlen will do what I tell him to. So just relax and enjoy the ride.
And now the star of our show, Tex Ritter.
I dreamed I was out in hillbilly heaven. Oh, what a beautiful sight. Last night I dreamed I went to hillbilly heaven. You know who greeted me at the gate? The old cowboy philosopher himself, Will Rogers. He said to me, he said, Tex, the boss of the riders up here has kind of asked me to show you around. Right over yonder's a few of your old compadres. My, was I glad to see them. Hank Williams and Johnny Horton and Hawkshaw Hawkins. Jack Anglin and Randy Hughes. Rod Brasfield, Cowboy Copus. I dreamed I was there in hillbilly heaven. Oh, what a beautiful sight. He introduced me to Wiley Post, and he showed me the Hall of Fame with all the gold guitars and fiddles hanging on the wall. Then he said, Tex, step this way. More of your friends I know you won't see. They're waiting for you. There they were, standing side by side, smiling at me. Patsy Cline and Texas Ruby, Carl Farr of the Sons of the Pioneers, Little Joe Carson of Texas, Merle Lindsay, Jim Reeves and Hank Martin, Ira Leuven, Wiley Walker, the Delmore Brothers, all the rest. I met all the stars in hillbilly heaven. Oh, what a star-studded night. Ask him who else he expected within the next, say, 100 years. He handed me a large book covered with stardust. Will Rogers called it the Big Tally Book. In it were many names, and each name was branded in pure gold. I began to read some of them as I turned the pages. Red Foley, Ernie Stubb, Gene Autry, Roy Acuff, and Eddie Arnold, Porter Wagner, and Sonny James, the Wilburn Brothers, Loretta Lynn, and Ferlin Husky, Farron Young, Minnie Pearl, Johnny Cash, Tex Ritter, that's when I woke up. And I'm sorry I did, because I dreamed I was there in hillbilly heaven. a beautiful sight.
Thank you, Tex. And now a special treat. A new young singer in his first Nashville performance. The Black Poodle is happy to present Arlen Grove.
I've been chasing the big wheels all over Nashville, waiting for my big break to come. Living on ketchup soup, homemade crackers and Kool-Aid. I'll be a star tomorrow, but today I'm a Nashville bum. I look good in cowboy clothes and I sing through my nose. Webb said that's the way to get her done. I smoke good old PA like the Opry stars, they say. I'll be a star tomorrow, but today I'm a Nashville bum. Well, a friend of a friend of mine is a friend of Op Divine's, and he finally got me on the Opry show. I walked out like a star, tripped and busted my guitar. I'll be a star tomorrow, but today I'm a Nashville bum. Well, here's a song I wrote by myself, note for note, with a lot of help that might make number one. If you can change a word or two, and I'll give half of it to you. I'll be a star tomorrow, but today I'm a Nashville bum. Yes, I'll be a star tomorrow, but today I'm a Nashville bum.
Hey, boy.
Yes, sir?
You got yourself some talent.
Well, thank you, Mr. Ritter.
Just call me Tex. You know, we could use some new blood in this business. Give it a whirl.
Well, I'd sure like to try it.
Fine. Just a little advice. When you hit the road, don't drive too fast. Hang on to yourself. Oh, one more thing. Don't go wild, boy. You hear me?
Yes, sir.
Howdy, neighbor, howdy, get out, we'll come right in. We'll make a full race, stop your business in. About a pot of coffee and a burning candy. Looking down the country and we'll meet a hungry man. We're so glad to see you, been wondering how you've been. Everybody's been a fine, let the fun begin.
Well, howdy everybody, and welcome to our show. We've got a lot of special guests today, and I think a real good show lined up for you. Have the Wilburn brothers, Miss Loretta Lynn, and a fella that's only had out a couple of records, but one of them already has been to the top, called the Nashville Rebel, and his new one called Green River. And his name is Arlen Grove. He'll be along in a few minutes, but right now let's do a little number called Country Music's Gone to Town.
Oh, they said country music's gone to town. Old Joe Clark's done put on a cap and gown. What's a country boy to do? What's this world coming to? Oh, they say country music's gone to town. Well, Grandpa used to take his dear old fiddle on his knee, and Uncle Buck would get the banjo down. The only music ever heard that would stop the mockingbird. Now they say the country music's gone to town. Oh, they say the country music's gone to town. Oh, Joe Parks done put on his cap and gown. What's a country boy to do? What's this world coming to? Oh, they say that country music's gone to town. One day I was walking through the canyons and the hills. I came up on a cabin far away. An old man with his banjo sat there patting his big toe, and as he played it you could hear him say, oh, they say that country music's gone to town. Old Joe Clark's done put on a cap and gown. What's a country boy to do? What's this world a-coming to? Oh, they say that country music's gone to town.
Thank you so very much. You're awful nice. And right now I want to introduce our first special guest to you. Here's a couple of boys that have a television show also that's carried all over the country. And it's a real pleasure for me to introduce them on our show. I know you'll enjoy them, so let's make them welcome. Teddy and Doyle, the Wilburn Brothers. Glad to have you all with us.
Thank you, good sir. To be here.
Well, you all are looking great and been busy, I know, as you could possibly be.
Yes, we sure have.
And, how about you introducing another special guest? We've got all kind of guests today.
Well, the Wilburn Brothers couldn't get along without our sidekick beside us. So here's Loretta Lynn.
How you doing?
I'm good.
Good to see you. You all have got a song picked out, a Christmas song, haven't you?
Yes, it's a song called Christmas at the Opry. We thought it might cool things off a little bit, okay?
Yes, well, let's hear it.
All right.
I want to be at the Opry on Christmas night, the grand old Opry on Christmas night. I want to be there when the biggest names of all come back for a Christmas curtain call. I want to be at the Opry on Christmas night, the grand old Opry on Christmas night. Remember the Opry stars from the late great years. You smile even though you wipe away some tears.
What's that sound making all the clouds go? Oh, of course, it's Uncle Dave Macon and his old banjo. I can see him now, keeping time with his feet, singing 11-cent cotton and 40-cent meat.
And as the applause dies down, there's another sound, swelling from the heavens and memories abound, of our friend Hank Williams and his lonesome sigh, of cold, cold heart, and I'm so lonesome I could cry.
And Rod. Rod Brassfield. What a funny guy. He's there, too, at that opera in the sky. Keep him laughing, Rod, way up there in the blue, and from all of us, a Merry Christmas to you.
Cowboy Copas, Hawkshaw Hawkins, Jim Reeves, and Patsy Cline, singing all the great songs that made their stars shine. We still miss you, and we want you to know, someday we hope to join your Christmas Grand Ole Opry show.
I want to be at the Opry on Christmas night, the Grand Ole Opry on Christmas night. I want to be there when the biggest names of all come back for a Christmas curtain call. I want to be at the Opry on Christmas night, the Grand Ole Opry on Christmas night. Remember the Opry stars from the late great years. You smile even though you wipe away some tears.
Thank you, Porter.
Thank you, Doyle. Teddy, thank you very much. And Loretta, beautiful job. They're wonderful people, and it's so nice to have them on the show. You know, I've had the pleasure of watching lots of young artists rise to stardom, and what a pleasure it is to see someone really become established when they work real hard. Here's a guy that has really worked hard his career. Had out a song called The Nashville Rebel that was a real big hit for him, and he's got one now I think it's going to even be bigger. Let's give him a great big welcome. His name is Arlen Grove. How about it? Arlen?
How are you, Porter?
Oh, I'm fine, and it's such a pleasure to have you on the show with us. You've been doing...
It's a pleasure to be here.
You've been doing great, man.
Well, thank you very much.
You have out a new song called Green River.
Yes, sir.
Right?
On RCA Victor Records.
Right, and a good one, too. Would you like to do it for us?
I'd really like to.
I'll loan you my guitar.
Well, I'll appreciate it.
Oh, okay.
Thank you.
Green River, I come back to you. Do you remember me? Do you remember Molly? With the soft blue eyes.
Hey, turn that off.
I left here.
How long does it take to cook a steak?
About 20 minutes. Why?
Well, I figure Molly ought to be starting right about now.
Celebration?
Have 3 weeks on the road and out the first thing in the morning. You better believe it. Just sweet Molly and me.
Sweet Molly will have to wait.
Can Arlen Grove appear on the Grand Ole Opry tonight? Request immediate reply, Tex Ritter.
Well, can he?
You better believe it. Tonight, old Ireland's gonna be on the Grand Ole Opry in Nashville, Tennessee.
Oh, honey, I've got the most wonderful news.
Well, you hear my news. Tonight, old Ireland's gonna be on the Grand Ole Opry in Nashville, Tennessee.
Tonight?
Tonight. In 2 hours, I'm going to be on that old wooden stage with the greatest, Tex Ritter and me. Look, hon, I'm in an awful hurry, though. Would you please get my gold jacket while I take a shower?
Do what you do, do well. Do what you do, do well.
just great. You know, the Grand Ole Opry has always prided itself in bringing you the very top names in country music. And tonight we're going to bring you something special. We're going to bring you the sounds of a great new boy who has a great hit record you've heard called The Nashville Rebel, and this is his first time on the Grand Ole Opry. And I want to hear that applause out there that he so richly deserves. Let's make welcome for his Grand Ole Opry debut, Arlen Brough.
Traveling down this lonesome railroad, silver lines of motion. A million miles of cross ties mark a million miles I've been. I pick peaches down in Georgia, apples up in Maine, pull cotton out in Texas, riding on a train. I was just a lad of 17, my daddy turned me loose. Silver ribbons calling me, engine and caboose. I can't recall my mother, she left when I was two. Brunettes, blondes, and redheads were the only love I knew. Don't ask me where I'm going. Don't ask me where I've been. One more time, back again. Traveling to the tune of freight wheels is such a lonely sound. Hear that lonesome whistle blow as we leave another town. I wish someone was waiting somewhere to welcome me. Then those silver ribbons would see no more of me. Don't ask me where I'm going. Don't ask me where I've been. Those silver ribbons will take me there, there and back again. One more time, back again.
Arlen, you were marvelous.
Thank you, Margot.
I'd like you to meet the big boss man here at the Opry, Mr. Art Devine.
It's a real pleasure, Mr. Devine.
Thank you, Arlen. It's a pleasure to have you. You did a great job, and you've got a great future ahead of you, boy.
Thank you.
Just wonderful.
You know, one of the greatest thrills of my life is appearing on the Opry tonight.
Well, thank you.
You know, you stop and think of all the great artists that have appeared on that very same stage.
Oh, it's been going on a long time. 1925 it started. It was started then by the National Life and Accident Insurance Company. Been going on ever since.
That is a long time.
Arlen, we have to meet Tex Ritter over at Tootsie's. Will you excuse us, Mr. Devine?
Certainly, Margot.
It's a real nice meeting.
I want to see you again on this stage, Arlen, real soon.
Thank you.
Good night.
Nice to see you. Bye.
Well, young blood, glad you could make it. You did fine. Fine.
Well, you told me to give it a whirl, and I'm whirling. So this is Tootsie's.
This is Tootsie's. This is it. You see these walls? Whenever anybody makes it on the Grand Ole Opry, Tootsie gives them a can of paint and a brush. Has them sign their names here on the wall.
I'll drink to that. Say, I'll tell you what. Let's go get Molly and have a real celebration.
Why not?
Now, you folks go ahead. Have a good time. I got to get back to WSN.
Mm-hmm.
What's the matter, Arlen?
Molly left me.
Oh, poor baby.
What the hell are you doing?
Molly's gone.
Who the hell understands about women? They're all alike.
Not Molly. She's different.
Is she? You know what I think? I think sweet, pure Molly is a hustler.
Now, you hold on, Miss.
No, hear me out. There she was, ripe, 21, wasting away in a one-pump gas station. Along comes Arlen Grove, fresh from the Army with $1 million talent in his hip pocket. Now, she hitched herself to a star, yours. Well, she was the first one to hear you sing. She dragged you to the Hootenanny. And you don't think it was you that seduced her that night her old man caught you? She got herself quite a ride. Beautiful. All the way to Nashville. Beautiful apartment, new car, mink coat. I'll bet you she took that mink.
Who are you, Wesley? I really don't know you, do I?
It's gone.
You see?
I'll make some coffee. That was rotten, Wesley.
Oh, come on. Now, let's go. We can celebrate without him.
No.
No? What do you mean, no?
I'm gonna take care of Arlen.
His bedroom ought to have swinging doors. Save time between cramps.
Don't you ever call me that again.
You listen. I don't give a damn who you bed down with, but not with him. Not with my property.
Your property.
That's right.
Oh, you really are sick.
Shut up!
Rough trip?
Oh, it was all right.
That's your mail.
Nothing from Molly?
No. Why don't you forget her?
I can't. I love her.
Oh, that feels good.
You're well trained, Arlen.
Yeah.
Then Margot's an excellent trainer. Years of experience.
All right, Wesley.
She's terrific with horses. Especially studs. You do know about studs, don't you, Arlen? What are you trying to say? Just a little friendly advice. You married one tramp, don't try for two.
Arlen, no!
I made him! I'll break him!
It's crazy, Wes. I can't book a country singer in the consort. Our society audience will murder him. Absolutely not.
Listen, you owe me plenty of favors.
Do you know what you're doing?
I know exactly what I'm doing.
Mm.
Good evening. Welcome to the concert. Right this way, please.
And now the consort presents for the first time in Chicago, Harlan Grove.
Thank you. Thank you very much. We're going to do a few country songs for you, and just like they always say, country music's like courting an old maid. You can't overdo it.
They call me the Nashville Rebel. They say, leave that boy alone. Don't you give him advice, or he'll turn to ice, and you might as well talk to stone. But I've got things to do and things to say in my own.
I got a new dog yesterday.
I really don't. I'm the Nashville Rebel. I'm a loner and I like it fine.
Oh, really? But they're so big.
I live a normal life, but I just don't have the time. Cause I've got things to do and things to say in my own way. I've got things to do and things to say in my own way.
Are you sure this is the right thing?
Yeah. I want to take him down a peg.
I'll do it, but I think you're nuts.
Ladies and gentlemen, the consort takes great pride in presenting Mr. Henny Youngman.
Folks, if he's got any talent, it's Elvis Presley's name. Some people bring happiness wherever they go. He brings happiness whenever he goes. One critic heard him sing. He said, if that's harmony, I'll take grits. But you believe he wanted to be an atheist once? He gave it up to have no holidays. He wants to get out of the country in Westernfield. I just want him to get out of the country.
Wes, you should have heard them.
Why?
They were laughing at me.
I know.
But why?
Sit down, Alan. Sit down.
I've got some bad news for you, boy. You're finished.
I'm what?
Finished.
What are you talking about?
I'll try to make it very simple. You just got laughed out of the business.
I'll do better next time.
There won't be a next time. You just don't have what it takes.
But what about all the places where they wouldn't let me off the stage?
I can't afford any more places like that, Arlen. You still don't get it, do you? All right, I'll spell it out. All those people who cheered and screamed and tore your clothes, well, they didn't come because they loved you or because you're a great singer. They came because I paid them.
Paid them?
That's right.
I don't believe you.
You don't. Tonight was the first time you had to sing in front of a legitimate audience. And you died.
All right. So I died here. But what about the Grand Ole Opry? Remember what Tex Ritter said?
I know what Tex Ritter said. What I told him to say. He owed me a favor. He paid off. The free ride is over, Sonny. I'm writing you off as a bad investment. Yeah?
Is Arden there?
No. Why?
Molly's sick. Oh. And she's pregnant. You tell that boy I want to talk to him. Just as soon as possible, you tell him I want to see him.
I'll do that. I'll just do that. How should I know? He ran out on me 2 weeks ago.
Mr. Atkinson, too, says it's urgent.
Yes, Chet.
Grove was due here 4 hours ago for a session. Where is he?
He went on the bottle a couple of weeks ago in Chicago. I haven't seen him since.
Who's going to pay for the musicians?
Oh, I'll take care of it. He's still my boy.
Lucky you.
Yeah.
What happened in Chicago?
I booked him in the finest room in the city. Wonder Boy couldn't cut it. He folded, dove in a bottle.
What room?
Not important.
What room, Wesley?
The Consort, if you must know.
The Consort? There isn't a country singer in the world who could make it there. You misbooked him on purpose, didn't you?
All right, that's enough.
You sick, twisted little man.
I warned you, that's enough!
Wesley, you stink.
Just a minute.
Oh, swell.
Well?
Go wash and shave.
You just hold on a minute.
Go on.
Okay, what's happening?
You're taking me to dinner.
Time's sake?
That's right. For old time's sake.
Okay.
Operator, get me the Country Western Club, please. Thank you. Could I talk to the manager?
What now?
Why did you run away?
Because I thought I was a singer and found out I was nothing but a clown.
That's not true.
You didn't hear him laughing.
Arlen, why won't you believe Wesley set this whole thing up deliberately to tear you down?
It doesn't make any sense.
Well, it does to him. He's a sick man, Arlen. Anything he can't own, he has to destroy. And he's trying to destroy you. And without your music, you're dead.
Let me tell you a secret, Margot. Once I could hear music in everything, Molly could hear it too. And together, we were going to teach the whole world to hear it.
Oh, you still can?
No. I've listened. And all I can hear is people laughing.
Well, then maybe you better listen harder. You lost a part of your life when Molly left. Are you trying to throw away the rest of it?
That's enough, Margot.
No, it's not enough. If you let Wesley win without fighting back, you're not only finished as a singer, Arlen, you're finished as a man.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a very special treat for you this evening. Arlen Grove, the sensational Arlen Grove, is in our audience. Let's give him a big round of applause. Bring him up to our stage, and perhaps he'll do a number for us.
This is your idea. It's a loser.
Wesley's gambling he'll quit without a struggle. Me? I'm betting Wesley's wrong. I'm betting you're a man.
Let's try one. Tennessee. Oh, what I'd give to be back there once again with all the old friends who were so kind to me in Tennessee. I was happy as could be. Never got too much done, but living sure was fun in Tennessee. This big city just depresses me. Oh, everybody's as kind as can be. A homesick like I could sing all night.
But he isn't drinking anymore, Mr. Cooper. No. Now I understand. Yes. Goodbye.
I guess everybody's heard about alcoholic Arlen. I couldn't get a job picking feathers.
Come in.
Mr. Grove?
Yes.
Arlen, heard you're in trouble. Come to the Opry and let's talk about it. Tex Ritter. Send this answer. See you tonight. Signed, Arlen Grove.
Thank you, Mr. Grove.
We better hurry. We've got an airplane to catch.
I suppose I ought to say congratulations, for you've won the only girl I'll ever love. But I hurt too much to face the situation. So take good care of her. Take good care of her. I must accept it. She loves you more than me. So with my broken heart, I'll bow out gracefully. Please don't send me any wedding invitation, for I couldn't bear to see her there with you. If she's happy, that will be my consolation. Just take good care of her. Take good care of her. Take good care of her.
You know, you folks drive hundreds of miles to see the very best, and you're going to see it right now. Here's a young lady who's America's number one country girl singer. She's going to sing You Ain't Woman Enough. Here is Miss Loretta Lynn.
You're not going on. I said don't
bother. Shut up.
Your own, Grove.
Hmm. I said no!
From now on, I'll take care of myself.
Take care of yourself? You can't even take care of your wife.
What about Molly?
She's pregnant and she's dying.
Your own, Arlen. Get out there.
And here he comes now, Arlen Crowe.
Friends, I can't sing for you tonight, though I am mighty proud that you've asked me to. My wife, Molly, is in the hospital. Molly, if you can hear me, please wait for me. I'm coming, and I love you.
Molly, are you all right? And the baby?
I've named him Arlen.
Folks, I just heard from the hospital that Molly Grove is going to be all right. This next song is dedicated to Arlen Grove, Jr.
Green River, I've come back to you. Do you remember me? I've come back to you and Molly, with the soft blue eyes. I left here with a lot of dreams, but none of them came true. What I wanted was here waiting all the time. What I wanted